So let's take a look at another example here. Here, a dental hygienist conducted some research and recorded the ounces of sugar consumed weekly and the number of cavities observed amongst 12-year-old children. And it looks like there were six of them. Is there evidence to suggest a relationship between the amount of sugar consumed weekly and the number of cavities? Well, right away, you would expect something like this. If I were to do a scatter plot, you'd expect a scatter plot to look something like this. Some sort of linear trend to it. Because you expect as you have more sugar, you eat more sugar, you expect the cavities to also go up. So I'd expect a linear trend. So let's take a look at this data and see what we get. So here I have the sugar. I'm going to make that a ratio. A number of cavities is also a ratio. And then I'm going to go back and do a scatter plot. And I don't want the pollution index. I want the sugar on the x-axis and number of cavities on the y-axis. And again, actually, I'm not going to do anything except for look at the scatter plot. So I'm going to turn everything off. Although you can't turn the hypothesis test off. We just ignore that for right now. So what I'm really interested in is the graph. And I'm looking at this, and it looks, there's curvature. This is not very all that linear. You can see there's some curvature going on here. Now, that may be a little bit difficult for you to see initially. But the easiest thing to do is if you just draw a loose line around it, you're going to see this slight bend to it. So I'm thinking this is probably a pretty good candidate for Spearman's correlation. Now, Spearman's is based on the ranks. So let's go ahead and take a look at what the ranks mean. Sugar ranks, zero sugar, that is the smallest value that will get rank number one. Sugar of one, I believe it was ounces or grams, I don't remember how they measure it, it doesn't really matter, but this would have a rank of two. The next biggest would be four, which is rank three. Nine would be rank four. This would be rank 5, and this would be rank 6. 0 would be rank 1 for the cavities. Looks like 5 would be rank 2. 6 would be rank 3. 8 would be ranked 4. 9 would be 5. And 10 would be 6. So what I want to do now is ignore this data. Pretend that data no longer even exists. And I want to do a scatter plot of just the ranks of the data. Okay, I'm going to set the sugar ranks to ratio. Although Spearman's correlation works with ordinal data, the way the program is doing TC stats, it really needs at least interval ratio. But you know, if you have ordinal data, you can't apply this technique. You just need to name it as interval ratio. That's something we need the programmers to work on to get that worked out. So now I'm going to do a scatter plot, and I'm going to select the sugar ranks and the cavity ranks. I'm going to turn all of these off. So now if I graph it, what I see is an extremely linear trend. There's no doubt that this baby is linear. This is incredibly linear, very, very strong association. Now if I go back and let's look at the original and graph it, now you can probably see this curvature is a little bit more obvious now. Okay, I want to make a couple points here real quickly. This is the original data. And remember we said that Spearman's correlation was nothing more than Pearson's conducted on the ranks. So I'm going to use the original data, and then I'm going to tell it to calculate both Pearson's and Spearman's correlation coefficients. And I'm going to leave the residual stuff off. That has to do with linear regression. We'll come to it a little bit later. And I'm going to set my null hypothesis to 0, or equals to 0, alternative is greater. And I'm going to go ahead and give it a 95% confidence interval. Okay, now when I graph this, I get the same graph. This is the original graph. That's not a big surprise. If I turn the regression line on, that might help you see. That's actually a regression line, which we'll talk about later. That's the best fit line. That may help you see that the data has curvature to it. You may be able to see this curvature a little bit better now. But anyway, if I go back to results, and here's the Pearson's correlation, 0.77, and here's Spearman's, 0.94, clearly much stronger. And then here's the individual p-values along with the 95% confidence intervals. So now I want to go back, and just again to prove a point to you, remember what that correlation was, I'm going to select the ranks, and do both Pearson's and Spearman's. Now I graph it, I get that graph, which is very linear. If I turn the regression line on, it makes it more obvious that it's very linear. Select results, and I see the p-values and the correlations are identical. That's because this is working off of the ranks. Now, there's no need for you to actually rank the data. Obviously, TCStats does that for you. All I have to do is recognize I'm working with curve data. There's no reason for you ever create ranks. Just select the raw data, and then if you think it's curve, use Spearman's correlation coefficient, graph it, check your results, and there is a confidence interval, a p-value for the hypothesis test, and the value of Spearman's R. So again, as I said earlier, I would state that a null hypothesis of rho sub s equals zero, which is no trend, and the alternative hypothesis would be rho sub s is positive, and then alpha of 0.05 as usual. And then we ended up with a p-value of 0.0004. So my decision would be to reject the null hypothesis, and the conclusion is that there is evidence to suggest, I'm going to say a positive. Now you may or may not want to say monotonic. Depends on your audience. A lot of people have no clue what monotonic means. So you may just want to say a positive trend. Between cavities, or I should say sugar. And cavities. And again, just as with Pearson's correlation, you need to make sure you understand that Spearman's correlation does not equal causation. They're not the same. It may be a contributing factor. Sugar may certainly be contributing, but you can't say it by itself is causing more cavities, not based on correlation.